Computers. That's what my TED Talk is about today, how computers work and what we can do with them. I like to see the distraught faces in the crowd when I mention that and how scared some of you look. And yes, I see you English teachers in the back getting ready to doze off. But what if I told you they aren't hard to understand? And they are certainly not boring. Well, quantum ones aren't anyway. In 2005, David Dutch said in a TED Talk, not as cool as mine, that quantum computation will be the first technology that allows useful tasks to be performed in collaboration between parallel universes. Can you imagine what that could mean for society? And you and me, the thinkers and innovators of the new world, will be working alongside it. So I'll kindly take the time out of my day to explain it to you, doing the future you a little favor. Now, what makes quantum computers so amazing is that they can deal with complex situations. But complex situations are nothing like deciding what to eat for lunch, although that at times can seem impossible. Complex problems are problems which involve many variables interacting in complex ways, so are unanswerable to a conventional computer. These problems can range from the world of retail business and finance to understanding the interactions of electrons in your body. For example, Amazon call you up and are in dying need of your expertise when thinking about the ideal shipping routes for their multinational corporation. You would need to consider the weather conditions, ideal routes but fastest routes, routes that don't disrupt any other boats, and then sailing restrictions, while the list goes on and on. Clearly, this problem involves millions of discrete decisions, which means the number of routing combinations we would need to consider would be larger than the number of atoms that exist in the universe. Now, a quantum computer can deal with all these possibilities and problems in one sitting, giving you your perfect answer. But how? The thing is with quantum computing is that it is hugely more complex than a traditional computer and operates in this Alice in Wonderland world of quantum physics, where the normal, everyday laws of physics no longer apply. And this is where things start to become a blur. But to clear your mind, let's start by looking at what is quantum. I'm sure you're all familiar with particles, whether they are marbles, grains of sand, atoms, and so on. So what if I was to show you an electron, the fundamental constituents of our universe? Well, in some cases, we know it acts as a particle, but in some cases, it acts as a wave. In terms of how we know this, you're just going to have to trust me on that one, unless you want me to explain the superposition of electromagnetic waves due to diffraction. Yeah, I didn't think so. But to put simply, in an experiment using two slits, we see this electron act as a wave, going through the two slits simultaneously, which leads to the question of how. It's impossible for two mutually exclusive events going through the left or right slit to happen at the same time. But they do. So we harness this weird and wacky phenomenon in quantum computing, using this ability to be both at the same time. But we'll revisit this physics lesson later on. Now, there are a range of different technological devices that we use on a day-to-day basis, and most, if not all, fall under the branch of a conventional computer. So what a conventional computer like your laptop does is take its variables using ones and zeros, which we call this really hard sciencey word, bits, and we use it to make the computer do something. So confusing, right? But with a quantum computer, this is where it starts to get a bit weird. Quantum computing is a process where these variables form qubits, quantum bits, which behave under the laws of quantum mechanics. This means information can be represented in special quantum states, where the ones and zeros we used before become a state of superposition, where they are a one and a zero simultaneously, just as the electron had the ability to go through the left and right slits simultaneously. So to try and make it make sense, let's think about if I flipped a coin and asked you the outcomes. Just as a conventional computer would handle the data, you would say it could either land on heads or tails. But for a quantum computer, it's as if the coin is spinning on its side. It's neither heads, but it's neither tails. It's sort of both, undecided until it falls. So to apply it to a real-life problem, imagine if I asked both computers to solve a maze. A classical computer uses a process trying every possible route until it reaches the end, using this chain of one and zeros until it works. But what if instead of using trial and error, we can consider all the possible routes simultaneously? This is what a quantum computer does, taking in all possibilities in one sitting. So for the maze, it holds all possible routes out of the maze and then reveals the likeliest path. So quantum computers will affect every industry. They'll affect tech security, to how we do business, to how we fight diseases. The list goes on and on. Clearly, the main challenge faces our generation can be summed simply: being able to supply reliable energy to our ever-growing population while addressing its risks on climate change. But businesses across the world are still working to finding a way to supply reliable energy, one of the most popular being electric cars. But the battery of an electric car to scientists actually remains a mystery. I'm pretty sure they just wear lab coats and pretend to know it all. But a battery is more like a complex ecosystem than a box that just spits out electricity. On a subatomic level, it's chaos in there. And quantum computers are working around the clock to sort it all out, trying to create a simulation designing more efficient energy production. So they are very much needed in our day and age. So by now, you can probably understand why quantum computing is such a revolutionary piece of technology, leveraging the bizarre characteristics of quantum physics to solve problems big businesses are thinking about. But what about for you and me? I didn't come here today to just tell you behind the scenes of your next day's shipping delivery. I came to talk about the future. Having still a while to go in terms of its actual application, it has been noticed that the properties seen in quantum mechanics can be used in the computer. And theoretically, the boundaries of quantum mechanics are endless. As mentioned, the qubit, similar to the wave-particle duality of an electron, can exist in two states simultaneously, the one and the zero, just as the particle had the ability to go through the left and right slit simultaneously. But I might have missed out one thing. This is because we are observing them in multiple universes simultaneously. So based on this, then, it is fair to say there are an enormous amount of parallel universes. I know it sounds crazy, but there is. There's a me who's a professional footballer right now, or a you that actually revised and passed your exams. Either way, a world in which the laws of physics are applied and obeyed, but different decisions were made, resulting in different outcomes. These decisions can be what you decided to eat for breakfast, down to the microscopic level of one particle going through a certain slit. Now, I know this is a lot to take in on a Wednesday afternoon, and I probably sound like a crazy scientist out of a kid's movie, but one real application we are using as I speak is quantum teleportation. Yes, teleporting. Quantum teleportation is a demonstration of what Albert Einstein famously called spooky action at a distance, also known as quantum entanglement. In quantum entanglement, one of the basic properties of quantum physics, we see the properties of one particle affect the properties of another, no matter the distance between them. So if you take these particles or entangled qubits as, say, dice, and split them up, you have the ability to transport information instantaneously. So if the dice was to fall on a 2, I could transport and know that the other one would fall on a 5. So quantum teleportation has the potential to revolutionize how we obtain and transport information. We don't actually know how to transport people unless, because I would be on a beach somewhere hot, you can trust that. But we may soon succeed in the future. Until then, that kind of spooky action is still in the distant future. So quantum computers are pretty cool. I mean, for a computer that's kept at minus 300 degrees Celsius, you'd think they would be. But they're not super boring. And we're now entering an era where the power and ability of these machines are going to reach crazy heights. So run with it. After this TED talk, you're pretty much as good as Steve Jobs. So I hope I have encouraged some of you to explore the crazy world of quantum computing, because I have a slight feeling you may already have, in another universe, of course.